Yeah, but come on, guys. She maced me.
It was completely unnecessary and aggressive.
You must have done something to set her off.
You know me. Am I the kind of guy who is going to set a woman off?
I set a woman off once.
We are discussing me, Michael. Can we please stay focused?
I think you did something to set her off.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
See, you've been setting birds off all over the place.
I haven't been setting any birds off. I've gone out of my way to behave like a gentleman at all times.
I definitely set a woman off once.
Please, can you just try to stay focused, Michael?
I was just saying, I mean, the 60s was a different time. You could set birds off by chasing them around the park.
You chased random birds around the park in the 60s?
Oh yeah, used to do it all the time. They loved it.
Well, I wouldn't be trying that now if my experience is anything to go by. But look, guys, we are talking about me. This is about me getting maced by that crazy woman who took over the last episode.
I still say you did something to set her off.
I did absolutely nothing to set her off.
So then why did she mace you?
Well, that was my original question.
You set her off.
I agree, you did something to set her off. Maybe you should have just chased around the park instead.
For the last time, I did absolutely nothing to deserve being maced.
You know, you look like a damn raccoon with those black eyes.
He does.
Like a crazy damn raccoon that runs around setting women off.
Anyway, it's time to get on with the next video. Some help you lot have been.
So, welcome to the next video, which is Dialed Part 1, Infinite Talk. And what you just saw there was exactly that, the use of Infinite Talk put Dell in DaVinci Resolve.
What we are going to do today is discuss that short clip and talk about making dialogue scenes.
The next video will be Dialogue Part 2, and we'll go into depth on getting better accuracy and more controlled emotion.
It was my first time putting something in theatre, so I had no idea what to expect, and it's been interesting.
I used Vibe Voice to date the audio. I didn't add reverb, but did add meadow ambience, which provided a cohesion to the scene. I used Audacity to cut the audio snippets to 3 to 5 seconds long. The longest I ran was, I think, 10 seconds on or 306 seg RTX 12GB VRAM. No problem, but took 20 minutes. The entire 1 minute video took 1 day to make.
Time and energy. We are back talking about them again.
Infinite Talk is good, but there are some obvious issues. I think I can address some of them, but I will get the next video. This approach way is faster. When I say faster, I mean I get it done in one go with one workflow. Next video tricks will involve a little more work to get a result, but also should end with more control over the results. That is video-to-video control nets. I have still to test it, but more on that next time. So let's break down what can we get done with Infinite Talk, talk about masking, about what worked and what didn't. I have, of course, shared the workflow in the text of this video. Help yourself to that. I have been getting some good feedback from you, Yid, and I need to address a couple of things. Yes, I will be talking about VACE for video swap-outs in a future video. Someone asked if I could organise all this better, and there are several reasons why I can't do that yet. One. Time and energy. I only have so much. Two. AI evolves so fast, these approaches, but soon be obsolete. Three. I plan to organise it better later, but my focus right now is on getting going with my next project. What you will find is that a bit of my stuff is shared on my website, markdkberry.dod, under research. So check there, so when it's on one place at least, and that is on the website. One other bit of feedback I'd like to address was...
The video you posted was too immature and schizo for me to watch.
Immature. Immature. Honestly, you go out of your way to give people free stuff and all they do is complain.
I am not immature. I am a man, a fully grown adult.
Michael,
pull my finger.
Oh, was he know if it was immature and schizo or he didn't watch it? Makes no sense.
He's right, though. It is immature and schizo.
Look, guy, please, can we just move on? Both the macing incident and this accusation of schizo immaturity. Let's talk brief about that realm of forbidden knowledge.
camera work and filmmaking. There are rules to filmmaking, and us amateurs arriving from AI don't know them. I never went to film school. So we must study movies and learn from them. Or awe. As you can see, I added some not-so-close-up camera shots over the shoulder. The problem with that is the lip sync gets weaker, and the results get blurrier. But this is all test and measure, guys. Test and measure. We are at the bleeding edge of AI open source ability at this time. Let's not forget that. Personally, I feel very proud to have this privilege, forging ahead into the unknown.
I think they key looking directly at pack camera breaking the fourth wall when it's done deliberately, but it's off-put at most of the time, I note. Well, I had to redo or trim it when it wasn't fitting to the visual context.
I already talked about having a bit of the other guys being kept in the side of the shot to give the dialogue a subconscious context, something I had never netted until I looked into it. And one thing that didn't work was go between the two close-ups here. It just felt wrong and I wasn't sure why, but I left it in. But I now have tote revision blindness to this, so please everyone give me feedback what you noticed, what worked for you, and what didn't. And I made fun of the immature and schizo comment, but I totally agree with it. So constructive criticism is welcome, and do your worst. I am Gen X. You don't get outraged by it, but that doesn't mean I won't jump you in the car park later and give you a wedgie. Let's now discuss a couple of workflow tricks which also presented problems. First is this shot, where I use masking to silence the two guys not speaking. But because of that, and because of the distance, the lip sync was very weak.
I think you did something to set her off.
And this highlights something else, guidelines I work to. I give a shot three goes, and if I haven't nailed it, I move on. When you make a 10-minute video that takes 80 days, you start to learn to manage your time and energy. Looking back at the masking, let's talk about how that works. Or in this case, didn't work too well, but I will address solutions in the next video. Using it, you right-click and mask the base image. I masked only their faces. It might work better doing the entire body. Try it. I have had this working better before. I just should not remember how. The nodes create a simple mask for each individual, and I add silence to the multi-talk node for two guys' audio slot. One and audio slot three. And the dialogue audio goes into slot two. That is the position set by the image and by the mask, so the workflow knows. That brings me to the prompt.
Make life easy on yourself. Make it generic as you can, so when you forget to change it, that won't matter so much.
I used a man in the middle is talking. The other two men listen to him, because in 99% of shots it will be happening. I had changed that for getting the moody face from me at the end. I was going to talk about reverb and ambience and using it to set the scene to sit right in the audio space. But I think I will save that for another video, as I am working on a thing I forkhook to my GitHub page. If you understand Python, you can download that and have a look. But I have plans to turn it into a custom node for Comfy UI at some point. And that will do for today. Next video will be about dialogue again, but using Fantasy Portrait with InfiniteTalk. I hope I have to do some more tests, so it won't be tomorrow. Oh, Christ, it's that woman who may stay. They're getting under the desk. Tell me when she is gone.
Is he here?
I haven't seen him.
Whose legs are those sticking out from under that desk?
This don't mess me out.
Is he always this ridiculous?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I came to offer an apology. Shall we say, my place, 7 p.m. tonight, bring wine.
Are you going to Macy again?
Not if you arrive on time.
7 p.m?
7 p.m. Okay then. Goodbye, gentlemen.
Why?
Oh, God.
No, it's wrong. It's so... I thought, don't bother getting my bite.
You're going to mace me again.
She's going to mace me again, isn't she?
I told you, you should never have set her off.
I set off a woman once. I was in a park back in the 60s.